na 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 na, like that. Then repeated the experiment, the crystalline structures were pristine and neat. Then he played rock music, rap music, what you hear in the cinemas these days, right? Our children with earphones in the ear going like this all the time. When he repeated the experiment, all the things were fractured. Why am I saying this? 70% of our brain is water. That's what our children are doing to their heads when they listen to this nonsense. Okay? So, how did this water know? Was the water able to read? There is some mysterious transmission occurring from the thalamus and the hypothalamus. And when you chant the mantras with the proper intonations, with the tongue touching at particular locations, when you inflect the sounds properly, observing the rules with the swaras, with the increase, with the decrease, with the extensions, the water is getting affected. Now you know, in a lake like Manasarovar, thousands of years rishis have sat there and chanted. All that stuff is in that water. And how do we know that? Drexel University, in the country where I am, they conducted experiments. And in that experiment, what did they find out? A small thumb-sized thumb drive with water as the base can hold 2 gigabytes of memory. Imagine what Manasarovar will hold. And you know why the rishis sat right next to flowing bodies of water. When they chanted, the people living downstream, they benefited from this thing. So this Masero Emoto experiments proved to me, this is why we have water in the Panchapatram, water in the Kalasam, water in the Shankam, right? All of those things are getting involved. Any questions? With this, somebody asked me, how do you keep, there are 150 young people in our temple, beginning at the age of, say, 12, all the way to about 30. They are the ones who, I am here, they are the ones who are running the temple right now. They may not know a whole lot of stuff about Sri Vidya, but the basic things they know, and what they know thoroughly. We have trained them and drilled them over and over again. Once a year we have an immersion camp. It's not called a camp because of insurance considerations. You call it a Saivite immersion. And without neglecting the Saiva Siddhanta part of my heritage, we have taught them the Tirumurais. All of them can chant Shivapuranam by heart. Why is Shivapuranam important? How many Tamilians here? Why is Shivapuranam important? Anybody? Why is it important? In a Shivalayam, where is the first puja done? Ganapati. Then Swami, Moolasthanam. Then Devi. Then Subramanya. Then Nataraja. If it is a small Tiva temple, Parivara Murtis are very small. There are not many of them. Then you do the puja to Bhairava, and you do Nandi and Bali, and go to Sandeshwara. If you chant the 95 lines of Shivapuranam, you get the value of having done the puja in a Shivalayam like this completely. Just once if you chant. And when should you chant it? There are clues for you left by the great ones all over the place. 5th century, Tirumolar. Kayame koyil kadimanam lingam ishanarku vai gopura vasal. Kayame koyil, kayam is body. The body is the temple. Kadimanam lingam, your atma swarupam is the linga swarupam inside. Ishanarku vai gopura vasal. And another clue is in the Sahasranama. Mahasadushashti koti yogini ganasevita. These are the combinations of the 23 chromosomes that are having, that you, a human being has in the cell. and a total of 6.4 billion. So each cell is capable of developing into anything it wants. At the beginning stage, it's called a stem cell. So when you do Abhishekam, what happens? You are doing Abhishekam to 6.4 billion deities. So the best place to do the Shiva Puranam is when you are bathing. You have to get up a little early for that, otherwise you will be occupying the bathroom for about 15-20 minutes more. Okay? Now these are some of the little things. How we attracted the people, young people to come to us was, we used to have a good band. We used to sing about 8 instruments and they were really good singers. We have melded the Sampradaya Bhajan Pattadi, that Dakshina Bharata Sampradaya Bhajan Pattadi, with from another culture. I have taken from the Kavalis, the Kavals, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan, taken his style and mixed both of them inside the thing. And the bhajans are called mantra bhajans. While we are singing, mantra is going on and pujas will be going on. By the time we finish Ganapati bhajans, Ganapati puja, Shodasavachara puja has been done. While they are singing the chorus, somebody is chanting the Mula Mantra. Somebody is going Ganapati, 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 Ganapati. Somebody is chanting Om Srim Hrim Klim Glaum Gam Ganapataye Varavarada Sarvajanam Me Vashamane Swaha Avahayami Stayajami Sampujayami Namaha. And then the person is going Ganapati, 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 Ganapati. Again Srim Hrim Klim Glaum Gam Ganapataye Varavarada Sarvajanam Me Vashamane Swaha Asanam Samarpajami. So, without their knowledge, with the love that they have for music, we slowly introduce this thing into them, and by the time we come to the Devi, they are trapped. Once she has the little kids in her web, she won't let go. Even if you want to let go, she won't. So, this is what we are doing. I think I've taken more time than I was allotted, right? I want to know whether you have any questions for me. Please. Don't think you are going to embarrass me. I have heard it all. My Guruji, he left for Sripuram during last year, Mahale Vaksham Sani Pradosham. He entered Sripuram. He used to tell me, Haran, use whatever technique at your disposal to give this knowledge to the kids. Because you are now on the disappearing side of the moon. God knows how many more years you have. You have to hand the temple over to them. And that we have. I have handed the temple over to them about a year and a half ago. And I have told them, day to day running of the temple, you are responsible. You do what you have to do. But I will be there watching to see whether the standards are going down. I understand why the mother, in her infinite grace, when you say Abhyaja Karunamurti, it is Abhyaja Karunamurti. She is that compassionate. I know why she taught me. I used to be an architect by profession. Went to school for about 12 years for this. And we had to study things like structural mechanics, balance, coordination, color combinations, matching of colors, contrast, scale. So anything done in the temple is always, because of the training, I always have this eye for scale and balance and evenness, and whether it is, you know, whether it is. My guru used to say, even if the product is very good, if the packaging is not okay, it will not sell. So that's what we are trying to do. I have to thank the Ratanpara Jnana Sabha for letting me speak and exchange or give my ideas to you, although none of you ask questions, right? Am I that boring?
No, not at all.
Let me conclude with one of my most favorite prayers. My most favorite hymn. Puluvai pirakkinum punniya puluvai pirakkinum punniya unnadi என் மனத்தே வழுவாதிருக்க வரம் தரல் வேண்டும் இவ்வையகத்தே தொழுவார்க்கிறங்கி தொழுவார்க்கிறங்கி இருந்த பாதிரிப்புலியூர் செழுநீர் புனல் கங்கை செஞ்சடை மேல் வைத்த தீவண்ணனே செஞ்சடை மேல் பாதிரிப்புலியூர் செழுநீர் புனல் கங்கை செஞ்சடை மேல் வைத்த தீவண்ணனே 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 திருச்சிற்றம்பலம். Let me translate it for the people who don't speak the great language of Tamil. Puluvai pirakkinum, even if I am born as a worm, punniya, O great one, unnadi, your feet, en manathe, let me not ever forget your golden feet in my mind, even if I am born as a worm. Unnadi en manathe, valuvadirukka varam taral vendum, that it should not even inadvertently slip away from my mind. Give me that boon. Right? Valuvadirukka varam taral vendum ivvayagathe, in this planet, in this earth, tholuvar kirangi. For those people, if you do this, Shiva is pleased. That is why in this Bilvashtakam it says, koti papa janma samharam eka bilvam sivarpanam, one leaf. That's all you need to give. And Shiva is reputedly so compassionate that he has gotten into trouble by giving boons left, right and center, like my Guruji. Padiripuliyur, this is a place where there is a Shiva temple. Padiripuliyur, Salinir Punal Gangai. Pure waters of the Ganga that issues from me. Senchadai mel vaita, in your flaming red hair, you have these things in your hair. Thivandane, the one who is of flame color. He's addressing Shiva, of course. This is called a Devaram. Okay, it's one of my favorite hymns because it reminds you that even if you are born 10,000 times, you should never forget her. Okay, thank you very much.